National Guard helicopter lifted the half-ton fossil last Thursday. 7 days later, paleontologists have a few bones out. You can see parts of the jawbone and some individual teeth.
This thing probably died out on the floodplain somewhere, and it was sitting there rotting, and then a big body of water came and washed it all together, kind of jumbled the bones.
Now the challenge is unpacking those bones and assembling the skeleton.
These guys want to be here in the museum on display. After 70 million years, you want people to look at you.
And look at the progress. The preparation lab is an exhibit where visitors can watch the process. Dr. Lucas says it's a fantastic opportunity for future dino scientists.
When I was a kid, there was no such thing as a natural history museum. So any kid in Albuquerque or in New Mexico who wanted to see fossils from New Mexico on display had to go out of state.
But this first baby Pentaceratops was found in New Mexico, and it will be displayed in New Mexico. Working with something so old and delicate will take about a year to complete. When finished, they'll begin work on an adult Pentaceratops, also unearthed last week.
Oh, Pentaceratops outside, and it got its name Spike during a contest about 30 years ago involving school children. And kids will be involved in another contest to name this baby Pentaceratops. They'll be asked to submit the name suggestions to the museum and then be involved in getting to vote on the winner. Reporting in Albuquerque, Robert Richardson, KOAT Action 7 News.